In the last slide, I showed you principle of X-ray reflection, how X-ray imaging telescope work. Here you can see actual slide of a X-ray imaging telescope known as Chandra. This telescope was named after the famous astrophysicist S. Chandrasekhar, who is of Indian origin. And this is one of the most sophisticated and, you know, complex instrument ever developed by NASA. And this has now been working in space for about last 10 years, more than 10 years. It is producing many stunning results. This telescope has sensitivity, which is unprecedented, comparable to the HST, the Hubble Space Telescope, in, which works in visible band, and this works in X-ray band from about 0.1 kilo electron volt to about 8 kilo electron volt. And it can produce images, X-ray images, which are comparable in angular resolution to the visible images. Therefore, it has been able to study a very huge number of very, very distant objects which are at the farthest edge of the universe, the quasars and clusters of galaxies and etc. The next slide shows an image obtained with the Chandra X-ray Observatory. This is an image of a star which is exploded in the year 1054, which is known as a Crab Nebula. Crab Nebula, you might have probably heard earlier, is remnant debris of a star which underwent massive explosion in the year 1054 AD. It was sighted by Chinese, Koreans and other Oriental astronomers. So you can see that here is X-ray image with a resolution of 0.5 arcsecond, and you can make out that a swirling cloud of gas which forms a torus-like structure. So these are the gas which glows in X-rays, and then there is a jet which is coming out from the center of this torus. Now the X-rays are produced in this by means of high energy electrons in the magnetic field of the supernova remnant. It's called known as supernova remnant. And when they get accelerated in the magnetic field, electrons radiate and they produce radiation ranging all the way from radio to gamma ray. So it's one of the best studied object. And this is the Chandra image. You can see the details which you can see are comparable to what you observe in the visible band. The next slide shows you a map of the sky as it appears in the X-ray. This map was obtained with a German imaging telescope known as ROSET or Ronstein telescope. And this map is plotted in galactic coordinates. So here is the galactic latitude and this is the galactic longitude. And each dot represents an X-ray source, and the size of the dot indicates the brightness of the source. So you can see that galactic plane is very bright. There are large number of bright sources. Most of these are what is known as X-ray binary stars. These X-ray binary stars are the brightest X-ray sources in our galaxy and other galaxies. And the X-rays are mostly emitted by transfer of matter onto what is known as a neutron star and a black hole. We'll come to that later. So about 100,000 sources are plotted here. Most of the sources at high latitude are extragalactic objects, namely galaxies, external galaxies, BLA objects, quasars, and other types of extragalactic sources. Next slide.